In the bustling district of Chinatown, Singapore, an HDB flat was engulfed in flames on the afternoon of Saturday, May 11. The incident resulted in the hospitalization of an elderly man, prompting a swift response from the Singapore Civil Defense Force, SCDF, and the evacuation of several residents as a precautionary measure. According to the SCDF, they were alerted to the fire at Block 5 Banda Street at approximately 2:25 p.m. The fire originated in the bedroom of an 11-story unit and involved a mattress. Firefighters promptly arrived at the scene and managed to extinguish the blaze using a water jet. During the firefighting operation, the SCDF rescued an unconscious individual from the affected unit. The emergency responders performed cardiopulmonary resuscitation, CPR, on the victim before paramedics transported him to the Singapore General Hospital. Reports indicate that the victim, a 68-year-old man, was unconscious at the time of his transfer to the hospital. In addition to rescuing the unconscious man, the police and SCDF evacuated approximately 15 other residents from the block as a safety precaution. The swift evacuation ensured that no further injuries were reported, and residents were able to return to their homes once the area was deemed safe. The SCDF has stated that the cause of the fire is currently under investigation. Meanwhile, local news outlet Xinmin Daily News spoke with a resident who provided additional context about the occupants of the affected unit. According to the neighbor, the original occupant, a man in his 60s, had moved out 2 to 3 months before the fire. A new tenant, described as a man in his 40s, had recently moved in and was reportedly less sociable with other residents. The neighbor described the harrowing scene, noting, "After the incident, I think it was because of smoke inhalation, he was put into an ambulance. When I saw him, his body was blackened, and he was wearing an oxygen mask." The fire in Chinatown has undoubtedly shaken the local community, highlighting the importance of fire safety and preparedness. As the investigation continues, residents are reminded of the critical role that smoke detectors, fire extinguishers, and emergency evacuation plans play in ensuring safety during such incidents. This tragic event serves as a stark reminder of the potential dangers that fires pose in residential areas and underscores the need for vigilance and prompt action in emergency situations. The quick response by the SCDF and the coordinated efforts of the police and paramedics were instrumental in preventing a potentially more devastating outcome. As the community comes to terms with this unfortunate incident, the focus remains on supporting those affected and preventing future occurrences. Residents of Chinatown and beyond are encouraged to stay informed about fire safety measures and to ensure that their homes are equipped with the necessary tools to combat and escape from fires. For ongoing updates on this story and other news, stay tuned to our channel 2230. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to keep informed about important events and updates. We welcome your comments and suggestions on how we can improve our coverage and keep you informed.
在新加坡繁忙的华埠地区，一间组屋在5月11日星期六下午发生火灾。这起事件导致一名老年男子被送往医院，迅速的救援行动和居民的紧急撤离也随之展开。根据新加坡民防部队 SCDF 的消息，他们在下午2点25分左右接到报警称班达街5号组屋发生火灾。火灾起源于11楼单元的卧室涉及一张床垫。消防员迅速赶到现场，并使用水枪扑灭了火焰。在灭火行动中， SCDF 从受影响的单元中救出了一名失去意识的人员。急救人员对该名人员进行了心肺复苏 CPR， 随后救护车将其送往新加坡中央医院。据报道，受害者是一名68岁的男子，他在被送往医院时处于昏迷状态。除了救援昏迷男子外，警方和 SCDF 还出于安全考虑疏散了大约15名居民。这次迅速的撤离确保没有更多的人员受伤，居民们在区域被认为安全后可以返回家中。 SCDF 表示，火灾的起因仍在调查中。与此同时，本地新闻媒体新民日报采访了一名居民，他提供了关于受影响单元住户的更多信息。 据这位邻居称，原来的住户是一名60多岁的男子，他在火灾发生前2到3个月搬走了。一名40多岁的男子最近搬了进来，并且与其他居民的交流较少。这位邻居描述了惊险的场面。事发后，我认为是因为吸入了烟雾，他被送上了救护车。我看到他时，他全身发黑，戴着氧气面罩。这起华埠的火灾无疑震动了当地社区，强调了防火和应急准备的重要性。随着调查的继续，提醒居民烟雾探测器、灭火器和紧急疏散计划在确保安全方面起到的关键作用。这起悲剧性事件提醒我们火灾在住宅区的潜在危险，并强调了在紧急情况下保持警惕和迅速行动的重要性。 SCDF 的快速响应以及警方和急救人员的协调努力，在防止更具破坏性结果方面起到了关键作用。在社区逐步接受这起不幸事件的同时，重点仍然是支持受影响的人员，并防止未来的类似事件发生。华埠及其他地区的居民被鼓励了解防火措施，并确保他们的家中配备必要的工具，以应对和逃离火灾。对于这起事件的最新消息及其他新闻，请关注我们的频道 2230， 记得点赞、分享和订阅，以便及时了解重要事件和更新。我们欢迎您的评论和建议，帮助我们改进报道，并为您提供信息。